Okay, so what we're gonna be doing is just learning basic rhythm. You know, we're gonna start from scratch, the very simplest of rhythms. You know, one, two. Called half notes. And you want to hit those so that they're right where they belong. So if we were in, say, a class situation where I'm really teaching you this to make you remember it, we do this for a long time. As boring as it is, we do it for a long time because we're practicing.
We're not just playing. What does that mean, a long time?
I might keep you doing this for 10 minutes. You know, just
so in practice we should do that?
Yeah. And this is just at the beginning stage. Because I want you to feel half notes. But I'm going to speed up the process a little bit because you're trying to put a lot into a short amount of time. So we're going to change this. Now that we understand half notes a little bit, we've got that sense of up, down, right, left, step, step. This is your basic rhythm. It's when you're walking. Step, 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 left, right, so you get, you know, it's inherent in most of us, but there are people that as soon as you put them a drum in front of them, they can't do it, even this, somehow their minds don't work right, so sometimes we have to work on it, yet our feet automatically will know how to do it, because we've been walking our whole life. So, then what we're going to move from there, is we're going to move into quarter notes. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I played this for the first 2 years of my drumming. I'm a very slow learner, but it was worth it, you know. And I'll tell you why in a minute. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Boom, left, tick, left. We're going to play slow intentionally. We're not going to let it speed up on us. Because that's part of learning to play as well, is to being able to play rhythm at any speed. Here you can already play for the dance. So we do this for a while because this is the basic beat you want to learn. For 4-4 rhythm, that's what it means. There's 4-4 notes. So we just learned 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, you know, 4 quarter notes or half notes. And now we're going to start to mix them together. And the way we're going to mix things together is in groups of four. Yeah, the way we're going to mix things together is in groups of four. Not that this is a rule, But it's like, if you listen to music, most music is structured in groups of four downbeats. And four, what did we call those things before?
Measures.
Four measures. And then it either repeats itself or a counterpoint comes in. Mm-hmm. And you know, sometimes it'll be a multiple or it might be eight, you know. But it runs in little groups of four. Now, this isn't a rule. Six is also a thing you'll find a lot of times. A group of six measures together.
Is that like 6-8? Is that what 6-8?
No, oh, that doesn't
okay.
mean 6-8.
Those
eight.
Aren't related. Okay, I was always wondering how you count 6-8.
It's just how it's structured. Yeah. And so, but most music, you know, like we're doing the Sri-Ram. Sri-Ram, J-Ram, J-J-Ram. Sri-Ram, J-Ram, J-J-Ram. You kind of hear how the melody revolves around mm-hmm. groups of four. So that's why we're going to group our rhythms that we learn into groups of four.
Okay.
Because that's a place where you can put a marker and then begin again on a little riff you're playing or something. So you learn to group things in groups of four. So in this case, we've got one, two, three, four, and we've got one, two. And so we're going to learn to put these together in different ways. This is important. This is what drumming's all about, is learning to mix different notes together, quarter notes, half notes, eighth notes, dotted notes, and mix them together into a measure. And that's what makes a rhythm. So early on, we're going to begin by moving back and forth between two little patterns, because that's what will give us the ability to create more complicated patterns as we develop as drummers. So, one, two, three, four, one, two. Well, it gives us a chance to go on a little bit farther because we're making this fast. You know, I'd have you play this a long time and then it gets in your fingers and the next time you come back, it'll be there and it'll be easier. And we're doing easy stuff right now anyway. But so we'll put this to a little group of four. We'll do three quarter note patterns and a half note pattern. So it'll look like this. Something to practice with. I'm going to give you another beat, another four beat pattern to put opposite this. We'll do something really simple, like four half notes together, half note beats together. So it'll look like this. I think I'll I'll change that into this pattern. So let's do that for a minute.
How does it start?
I'm just kind of setting things up to practice. So what I'm trying to teach you with this is to move between patterns fluidly. Be able to play quicker, slower, quicker, slower, you know? And so we're just learning to be able to move. And while it seems very simple, you know, and even with simple, you were starting to say, oh, where's this at? Well, while it seems very simple, it's going to give you a base to build upon. And sometimes you have to start simple and stay with it for a long time and build it and put that into your system, you know, so it's there. You understand the four beats in a four-quarter pattern. You know exactly where they're at. And you do this by repetition, you know, by doing it over and over. So I'm going to make it a little more complicated for you now. We're going to play the two patterns back to back. We'll start off with boom, left, back, clap, boom, left, back, clap, boom, left, back, clap, boom, left, boom, left, boom, left, boom, left, clap, boom, left, boom, left, clap, boom, left, clap, boom, left, clap, boom, left, boom, left, boom, left, boom, left,
I'm just following you. It's two patterns, and
this is why I would stretch this over a week instead of 20 or 40 minutes. Because, you know, we get so far the first day, I'd let that sink in, then I'd add something else and let that sink in. I'm going to...
Yes, yeah.
Excuse me? Did you get that?
Yep.
I'm going to keep moving along, you know.
What was that, three, two, three, two?
No, that was two patterns of four measures. The first one was three quarter note measures and a half note measure.
Right.
The second was two half note measures, a quarter note measure, and a half note measure. You know. So, and then we were just, you know, these two groups of four we were putting back to back. And the reason I'm doing this is to make you start to be able to flow. to be able to move easily between quarter notes and half notes.
Would that happen in one song?
Yes, often, you know, especially on the Dumbek, because especially as you learn more complicated patterns, you'll really start to be playing eighth notes and sixteenths rather than halves and quarters. And so this all is relevant as you build and become more and more complicated rhythms, you know. And we're just starting. So this is really the basis of rhythm. This is what's underneath. We haven't touched three-quarter rhythm yet. We're just working on four-quarter rhythm. So I'm going to add one more thing to it, because I want to give you a practice pattern to end with. You know, I might add two more things to it. You know, I usually do in the beginner's class. I give you four. I refer to these as letters of the alphabet. You know, we've got two letters right now. We've got a quarter note pattern that has four quarter notes in it, and a half note pattern that has two half notes in it. So we have two letters of the alphabet. There's only so many two-letter words you can make. You know, you get the sense of building two-letter words, and there's a limited number of two-letter words. So I'm going to give you a third pattern, and this pattern contains half notes and quarter notes both in the same measure. You know, so and this will be doom left left, you know, like this. So the doom will be a half note. So and so you can remember this by going grass. And they're beginning to deviate from an even-handed pattern, which is how the Dumbek is used. This will set you up for Arabic style playing in the future. Two patterns of four measures. The first one was three quarter note measures and a half note measure.
Right.
The second was two half note measures, a quarter note measure, and a half note measure. You know. So, and then we were just, you know, these two groups of four we were putting back to back. And the reason I'm doing this is to make you start to be able to flow, to be able to move easily between quarter notes and half notes.
Would that happen in one song?
Yes, often, you know, especially on the Dumbek, because especially as you learn more complicated patterns, you'll really start to be playing eighth notes and sixteenths rather than halves and quarters. And so this all is relevant as you build and become more and more complicated rhythms, you know. And we're just starting. So this is really the basis of rhythm. This is what's underneath. We haven't touched three-quarter rhythm yet. We're just working on four-quarter rhythm. So I'm going to add one more thing to it, because I want to give you a practice pattern to end with. You know, I might add two more things to it. You know, I usually do in the beginner's class. I give you four. I refer to these as letters of the alphabet. You know, we've got two letters right now. We've got a quarter note pattern that has four quarter notes in it, and a half note pattern that has two half notes in it. So we have two letters of the alphabet. There's only so many two letter words you can make. You know, you get the sense of building two letter words, and there's a limited number of two letter words. So I'm going to give you a third pattern. And this pattern contains half notes and quarter notes both in the same measure. You know, so. And this will be doom left left, you know, like this. So the doom will be a half note. So and so you can remember this by going grass, hopper, grass. Thank you. up for Arabic style playing in the future by learning to do this. Quarter notes and half notes in the same measure. So we'll go doom, left, left, doom, left, right, clap, doom, left, thank you. See, now we're on day three. Three and a half.
It's so meditative.
Wow, I'd like to go to a 3-day drum workshop with you. Yeah. We could come back and actually maybe be able to play for the
band. Yeah, because see, if you take your time learning this, it's going to sink in a little bit. Mm-hmm. We're really rushing it, and I'm trying to give you what I would probably give people in a week. And I haven't even gotten to the complicated patterns I'm going to give you right at the end. Because they're different nature, they're syncopated patterns, yeah. And we want to learn standard playing form. So now you have three letters of your alphabet. You have all quarter notes, all half notes, and you have quarter notes and half notes in the same pattern. You know, so you have three letters, and you can start to make a lot more words with three letters than you can with two. So what we're going to do here is we're going to put all three together in a pattern of four. And we're going to do it by playing two patterns we've already learned. We've learned the doom, left, left, doom, left, back, left. And we also learned doom, left, back, left, doom, left. So we'll do that for a second.
To cry and run in the other room. Well, I'm serious. It always comes up.
This. We'll see. You know, like I'm telling you, we're doing it way quicker than we should be learning. You know, so it's okay. She can run if she wants.
Yeah, it's okay.
And but I'm trying to give you something that you can take with you. So I'm going to end up with a pattern. I can add one more letter to it, but we may keep it here. And it might be just enough for you to work with. Mm-hmm. But so what this will be is your practice pattern to take home and practice with. Mm-hmm. And it'll be boom. Also, it'll be grasshopper, alligator, alligator, catfish. How's that? That'll help you remember it. You know, you relate it to something else. You know, this is a technique used to teach children. You know, and it works really well. You know, mm-hmm. You help them learn the rhythmic structure of the music through association with words they know, mm-hmm. and they can just see the patterns in the words. So, grass, alligator, alligator, catfish, grass. Thank you.
Grass, hopper, alligator, alligator, cat, fish. 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 Grass, hopper, alligator, alligator, cat, fish.
Okay, grass, well, that's a technique that allows you to remember this and find a way into the pattern.
That's helpful. Very helpful.
Like I say, it's one way they teach children. My friend's a music teacher who's over and schools, and this is the technique he uses for teaching children to remember the rhythmic patterns. And mm-hmm. he's teaching even on guitars and this mm-hmm. and that. You know, this is how he teaches them the pattern. Mm-hmm.
That's great.
It's useful.
Well, that's good, because I'm pretty sure that's who's learning this right now.
my
little kid.
but see, you're going to do that. You're going to keep this as a practice pattern. Mm-hmm. You're keeping it as a practice pattern for you to learn these three letters.
Right.
And after a month, maybe, or so, then what I want you to do is start to move them around.
Mm-hmm.
And start to and begin to listen to melodies you're playing for, because these will be in there.
Uh-huh.
And you can see how you can echo. You know, the doom's always on the down note. We're putting the doom on the down note. You know, because people are stepping on the down note, and we want the doom on the down note. If it's too busy, which it is sometimes, we might put the doom on the right foot, and on every other down note. You know, because sometimes it's just too much for the melody. But basically, what we're doing with our dooms and we're playing for the dances is we're helping people dance.
Mm-hmm.
We're putting the dooms on their steps, because as many of you have been in dance, circles mm-hmm. know, mm-hmm. not all of us are you know, motionally literate as each other. You know? Mm-hmm. I don't know if that's a word or not, but it's a sense of some of us had a lot of trouble even stepping to music. You know, we're out there walking, we're fine. All of a sudden we put music to it, and they can't step. You know, I've seen people. Mm-hmm. We do a rowing motion. You know,
we
step in, you step back evenly. One, two, just like you're walking. Mm-hmm. People cannot mm-hmm. do this. Because the music's going on, and the music has different melodic patterns in it, and their feet won't work like they would just if they were walking down the street, which they have no problem doing. So that's why we put a doom in there, right on the footstep, so eventually they start hearing that doom on the footstep, and they start to step in the right places. Because we're all at different levels there, and we work with, you know, theoretically, lots of the mass culture comes into dance right now and then. Some people just need help, you know, and some are just natural at it, you know? So that's why we do this, you know, and that's why we put the dooms there. I just wanted to give you a quick demonstration of maybe where you could go with these three letters, just so you get an understanding. What I want you to start doing in about a month, after you really have these three letters down, you know, and you can how you can start to just move around, and once you understand these, there's no problem moving between them, and you don't think about it, you feel it. See, all you have to do now is get these into your system, so they're just there. So if you want to go from this pattern to that pattern, you don't think alligator, or you don't think, you know,
I might.
That would be a song.
You don't think butterfly. You go, you feel the alligator, and you feel the butterfly, And you don't even think it, you don't even have to name it, it's there already in you, and you move into that with your feeling. You start using your feeling body instead of your thinking body. And this is what all good musicians do. They don't think about what they're going to play. When they get out there and improvise, it's not coming from, oh, I'll play, you know, C, D, and A. That's not happening. It's just
from a feeling.
All of a sudden they're going, they know what these notes feel like, and yeah. They just play them. Or they know what these chords feel like, and they move between them. So it eventually moves into your feeling body and comes from there. But you got to start somewhere, and the mind's usually involved in that process. So,
true.
Yeah, so that's what I want you to do with this. I could add one more note. Usually I add one more thing into this, and we've got four notes, four letters in our system. And because I use it a lot in the beginning, and it's called a dotted note. And it'd be a 3/8 note. It'd be... It'll never be sitting like that by itself in a melody. It'll be opposite, an even pattern. It'll be the syncopated opposite even. And what you'll find, usually, so you go. Let me think of a good animal we can have
right?
For that. Yeah. I'll think of it as, it'll come to me as we're doing it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So it's... put into a song. I was thinking of, 'tis a gift to be simple. That's where that's that dot in that beat. 'Tis a gift to be simple. 'Tis a gift. That's what I'm saying, like in a melody. Let me do the melody first so you can just feel that dotted note. 'Tis a gift to be simple, 'tis a gift to be free. You have a gift to be free.
Mm-hmm.
Notice the spaces in there.
Yeah.
And so you find it a lot. There's a lot of songs with it. I just took that one out. But, you know, for our purposes, we're gonna learn it in a pattern of four. We're going to go. Now I need a...
Oh, that was...
Yeah. So I need an animal. Boom, da, da, da. It's a long name.
Yeah.
Anteater.
Ant. No, it's a grasshopper.
It's got to be more syllables.
Anteater is a grasshopper. You know.
Yes, how many syllables?
It has four syllables.
Armadillo.
Armadillo.
Armadillo. Armadillo. Let's say it have to be like it.
Armadillo.
Armadillo. Okay.
Yeah, that would work. Yeah, so Armadillo. So an armadillo.
Is that right? That's the last one. Armadillo.
Right. We're going to use it for the dotted note. Mm-hmm. We're going to stretch arm out a little bit. You know. Madil is easy to put quick.
Yeah.
Low. Yeah, that'll work. That sounds good. Armadillo. So we have grass. Okay. Grass. Armadillo. Okay, I got it now. Catfish. Just something with two syllables.
Catfish.
Yeah, I'm just using an animal with two syllables so we can. Yes. So there. I just had to think it out. I'm not used to using these because I usually do left, right. I just decided to use all animals this time because it seemed
you.
To work.
It helped.
Yeah, it seemed to work, yeah. You know. So yeah. We have a grass. Slide for a minute, and this is the pattern we're going to leave you with to practice.
This one?
Yeah, you're not going to be. You probably won't play this pattern in dance. The whole purpose of this pattern is for you to learn these four letters. And like I say, in about a month's time, or if you're really quick at it, a couple of weeks. You know, it depends on how much you practice and how much you come back to it. You want to then start moving it around. Say, you know, something like. You know, grass, hopper, alligator, grass, hopper, catfish, catfish, you know, move it around and start mixing it up. So that, and the purpose of that is going to be to get you to flow, to get you to be able to move between any of these four patterns at any time you need it. And then the practice also is to start to listen to the dances. and listen to the melodic structure of the dances.
Mm-hmm.
You'll find these four things within that melodic structure. You know, and really basic. This is the base, the bottom of rhythm. This is the basis, and somewhere in that melodic structure, one of these four patterns is going to be there. Mm.